thanks for coming in.
Thank you very much. It's nice to be with you guys.
Now, can we clean it up at least for maybe, I don't know, 10 minutes, just a little bit?
Fox Sports Ohio's going against that memo. They got me in here on TV live. That's not a good deal.
I mean, you're not going to flip anybody the bird.
No, I'm not doing that. I've done that twice. Did it to the Giants announcers. Did it to the Rockies announcers. I've said worse things to both of you. Off
nightly,
the air.
Nightly.
So I'm going to play it straight tonight.
Okay. Four off the inside corner to load him up. You're going to miss the most what?
People. I'm going to miss you. I'm going to miss Chris. I'm going to miss Giesenslaw and Picoro. And
what about Jim Day? You miss Jim?
Not much. But Danny Graves. And,
hi, Jim. Sorry. I didn't have anything to do with it. You know, that last note there, though, and I was talking to our buddy Chris Spielman today about this.
Oh, yeah.
And talking about, you going into the Reds Hall of Fame.
You spend any time at all connecting in whatever capacity there might be with this organization, it's a special thing. In this town, it's very special. It's not something that I've ever taken for granted. In fact, when I came here in 1974, one of the writers at the news conference asked me today, did you think you'd be sitting here 46 years later? That's the last thing on my mind. I never dreamed about that, but also I never dreamed about coming to Cincinnati and being a big league baseball broadcaster as a springboard to go somewhere else. So the fact that, I'm one of eight guys that have been broadcasting at this level for 45 plus years and all with one club is something I'm very proud of.
Now, you have to admit, I mean, you used to be a pretty sharp dresser back in the old days when it was a total look in the 70s and wearing the suits and everything. But, I mean, now Amanda has you in these shirts.
No, these shirts were my idea.
They were not your idea.
Okay, that's fine.
There's no way they were you. I mean, Amanda's back here right now in the booth. She's nodding her head.
Tom.
I mean, come on.
Damn, you guys have a lot of dead air around here. What the heck is that all about?
Well,
are you all earning your money?
We let the picture do the talking sometimes.
And most time the viewers are very comfortable with that.
I could have taken a quick nap.
What is your advice to an aspiring play-by-play announcer? Doesn't matter what sport. What do you say to them to help them along their way?
I blow their minds by the question I ask them. My first question is, are you in love? And they look at me like I have three heads, and they say, well, what's that got to do with it? I said, are you in love? Because in order to get a foot in the door, you got to almost go to anywhere in the country and work for any amount of money within reason that station is going to pay you in order to begin your career. I still maintain if you get a job, which I think is the toughest thing to do in this business, and you're any good, your talent will take you to whatever level you're qualified to end up at. I am not going to be one of those guys that comes and shows up regularly and Chris, you lean over to Tom and say, hell, the guy just retired. Why didn't he stay home?
Would you say that about
him?
Don't
clutter up
the broadcast booth. I would say it, but would you
say it?
I might agree with you if you said it, but I probably wouldn't say it.
Jim Day would say it.
Oh, no. Jim Day would never say anything about mini-me, Marty Brenneman.
Yes, he would.
No. I'm surprised he doesn't have that same shirt you have on tonight.
What do you think about Tom and his career? I mean, that's got to make you almost or is equally proud for what he's done as to what you've done as well.
Well, for a number of reasons, and I agree with everything you said, Chris. One, I never pushed him into this business. There was never, ever any discussion between my only son and me about, well, why don't you follow into my footsteps and do what I've done? He's mentioned to me casually, I guess around the middle of his junior year, I think I want to do what you do for a living. And I said, that's fine. Never dreaming that he would have the success that he's had. And the nice thing about it all is the fact that I think it's drawn us closer and closer together because we can talk shop. I know Pete Rose used to say he's got good bloodlines. And I don't know what he inherited from me other than having a big mouth, but that's the way most Brennemans are.
frequently... And Amanda's in this situation now, and I can remember because of my mom,
yep,
and Sherry for a number of years, and then your two daughters in Dawn and Ashley. You know, I think so frequently they all get and have been overlooked so many times by your success or the fact that you and I do the same thing for a living. But I know to the very core and the very bottom of your heart that all of those people have been so near and dear to your heart and a big part of your career, too.
There's no question about that. And I agree with you 100%. And I imagine it transcends all cities in whatever level of celebrity that you're able to attain. 95% of it is all about you, and nobody ever thinks about the woman that you're married to and the sacrifices that you have to pay in order to allow your husband to reach the level of career that he wants to be at. And it's always how great you are, and it's never any mention about the person that has stood behind you and accepted a secondary role. And I think that's the reason why we go out of our way at times now to accept whatever nice things people say about us, but also include our wives in.
Dad, it's been awesome having you in here tonight.
It's been great to be
and
with a couple
of friends.
Enjoy
these next 48 hours. I love you.
I love
I'm
you
proud
too,
of you.
Thank you very much.
I'm happy
Chris.
For you.
Enjoy it,
and
man.
Amanda, and we're going to have a lot of fun.
You guys are the best.
Here the next couple of days. You don't want to flip anybody off before we go or
nope.
Anything like that?
I'll do that to Brantley when I get in the booth.
All right.
I'll see you.